Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about Mercedes developing an engine with a thermal efficiency of greater than 50%. So what does that mean? Well, if you take a gallon of fuel that's about to go into an internal combustion engine, it has a certain amount of energy. And what Mercedes has done is they've been able to turn about half of that, a little bit more than half of that gallon of fuel into useful work. So it has a certain amount of energy within it. Internal combustion engines are inherently pretty inefficient. And so Mercedes has been able to actually get more energy out of that than is energy wasted, which is contrary to almost every other engine out there, especially in automotive applications. Our cars are getting somewhere around 30% thermal efficiency, could be significantly less, could be a little bit higher. But this was developed in a test engine for Formula One. Now we're going to be talking about two of the different strategies which Mercedes employs, and these aren't unique to Mercedes, but they are the ones which have, of course, maximized the benefit of these two strategies, perhaps done it the best, as they're seeing the greatest efficiencies, and as a result, doing very well in Formula One from their previous research using these different technologies. So the first one, I think, is pretty well understood by anybody who follows Formula One. There is something called MGU-H, motor generator unit heat, which uses the turbocharger to spin up an electric motor. So you've got your exhaust that spools up a turbocharger that's connected to a shaft, which spins up an electric motor. That electric motor then sends power to a battery pack, which can then send that energy to another motor, which can be used to power the rear wheels. So the big advantage here is that you're turning waste energy from the exhaust instead into useful energy by powering a generator and then using that stored energy to then later accelerate the car. That's the huge advantage. Tuning it, of course, is a huge challenge, and it's something that Mercedes has done very well. Another unique thing that was, you know, a kind of a Mercedes innovation here was the idea of splitting the turbocharger on both sides of the engine block. So rather than having the compressor here and the turbine here, they've got the compressor up here, the turbine down here, and the generator in this center sandwich between the cylinder banks. And so what this does is it pulls that intake, that compressor, away from the exhaust turbine, and so it keeps it cooler. So you can bring in cooler air, you can use a smaller intercooler, you can make more power, you've got less piping, so it's more efficient, and you've got less turbo lag. So a lot of advantages of the setup that Mercedes chose to use. It can give them some aerodynamic benefits by using a smaller intercooler, things like that. So a very cool setup, but I think a lot of people know, you know, that this is done in Formula One, not done in road cars, but it's a huge advantage from an efficiency standpoint. Now, the other big advantage done in Formula One is the combustion process itself. So maximizing the amount of useful work you're able to extract during combustion. And this is done using pre-chamber combustion, which is quite different than what is done in our cars, where all of the combustion occurs within a single chamber, rather than in this little pre-chamber, which has your spark plug and a fuel injector. Now there's some differences here in what I've drawn versus what's done in Formula One, which we'll get into towards the end. But basically the way this process works. So you have your intake stroke just like normal. You pull in air, perhaps fuel. You could have direct injection or port injection with a setup like this. You pull in that air and fuel. You then compress it. Now there's this separate chamber up here, which has these little holes, these little ports down on the bottom of it. And so that chamber is able to pull in air and fuel through those little holes as you're compressing. So you're pressing that air and fuel up, and some of that air and fuel will go into this pre-chamber right here. Now, before it injects, before it fires the spark plug, you also have an additional fuel injector so that you can make the air-fuel ratio within this chamber really rich, so that you can ensure that you have good combustion occur. Now, outside of it, you're going to have really lean air and fuel. And generally speaking, if you have just a spark plug sitting in the middle here and a very lean air and fuel mixture, that lean air and fuel mixture does not promote good combustion. It doesn't all burn. And as a result, it's not that efficient. It can damage your engine. There's just problems associated with having a lean air fuel mixture if you're trying to use a spark to ignite it. Now the difference here is you have a rich air fuel mixture within this pre-chamber, then you have a lean air fuel mixture. So that's compressed, then your spark plug fires once you've got that rich air fuel mixture. That causes combustion to occur within this pre-chamber, and then you've got, of course, all those little ports. So a flame jet a turbulent flame jet will be, you know, forced out through each of these individual holes, spitting out this hot, fiery, these flame jets here, which then are going to force the leaner air-fuel mixture to actually combust. So it's going to spit out those flame jets. That's actually going to promote complete combustion of the air-fuel mixture rather than just an individual spark in the center. And as a result, you're able to use a lean air fuel mixture and get better efficiency because you're not using as much fuel in order to create power. You're using much leaner mixtures than is possible just using a spark alone. Now, keep in mind the ratio of fuel within this pre-chamber. Things aren't necessarily proportionally drawn here. It's going to be about, you know, 3%, less than 5% of the total amount of fuel will be within this pre-chamber compared to the rest of it. So though it is rich, it's a very small portion of the fuel. So overall, you have a huge benefit from using this lean air-fuel mixture outside of it, much leaner than you could do traditionally in combustion engines, and then using those flames, those turbulent flames, to combust that mixture. So that's one of the methods that is used in Formula One. I believe Mercedes was the first to do it. Other teams are now doing it. But that's one of the big benefits of their engine and how they're able to achieve crazy things like 50% thermal efficiency alongside using a motor generator unit, which is spun from the exhaust turbine. Now, I mentioned this is different from what is done in Formula One. And if you follow the rules closely, you'll know that in Formula One, you only get one fuel injector per cylinder. And so it's not going to have two like shown right here. So it may just have one and somehow it's able to, you know, proportionally inject a little bit more within that chamber. Perhaps there's one somehow divided between the two chambers, so there's some way it can divide between this pre-chamber and the larger chamber. But either way, that's one of the tricks of Formula One. You know, some of the things that go on behind the scenes that we don't exactly get to see that they have mastered is using a single fuel injector and being able to change the ratio, the air fuel ratio between the main combustion chamber and having a richer air fuel mixture within this pre-combustion chamber, which then ignites the rest of it. Part of the magic of F1, super cool stuff. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this video. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below.